Hey guys, and welcome to a new episode of Nomadic Dmitry channel. Today we're going to talk about OS 2. I've been trying to try OS 2 myself for a very long time, but something was stopping me all the time. For example, to install OS 2 you actually need to have floppy drives, like 3 floppy drives, and there are some problems installing this on a modern machine. There are always problems somewhere like it's stopping you. But then I decided to research it more and I realized there are basically two options these days. It's eComStation and ArcaOS. Well, ArcaOS is the latest one and I've decided to approach ArcaOS first. So actually I've even asked them on the official website through the contact form asking like, guys, can you provide me like demo version of OS so I can just basically try it and make a review? Well, I've got no reply. And alright, this is what I expected, so no big deal. I decided to try another approach, eComStation. With eComStation, there are more options and seems like it's still possible to use it. So I decided to take the eComStation approach. And I was able to find eComStation Live CD to play with it. And I actually installed it on my local machine as well. So like I found ways to install it on a local machine. I also wanted to show you how the installation process looks like. So here you will see the slides of OS 2 installation. So while I'm speaking about the OS, so you can just see this in action. Microsoft was more open to contacting with other vendors, like providing more drivers, making more communication with the users. Comparing to IBM, it was like closed platform, they provided not much marketing, there were like always some problems on that side. So most likely this is like the main reason why computer world was mostly based on Windows rather than OS 2, and like OS 2 is like a dead system at this point. Well, there are some people, there are some vendors who are still using it for specific purposes. It still exist in the ArcOS form, right? But I mean, it's really hard to get one and you need to like pay specific fee, like $100 or more to get a personal edition, and I'm fine with that. But how can I know that I'm actually will be able to use it? Like I should be able to at least have some demo CD or something. But what was my motivation to even try OS 2? Well, you see guys, during the 90s I was always using the DOS and Windows and basically the operating systems that Microsoft provided. But I also heard from some other people, including my friend, hey, you should actually try OS 2 and Linux. And Linux was easy to try, like it was really easy to get Linux and just like try to use Linux in those days. It was not that stable as now, but it was still possible to get Linux. But OS 2, I was actually confused how to get it as well. So even back in those days I was confused how to get OS 2 to actually try that. But I've heard that it's more stable than Windows. I've heard there are like more networking capabilities. I've heard that OS 2 does a better job of executing DOS and Windows applications. I always wanted to try it, but it's 2020 now, it is the first time I'm trying OS 2 based system, which is eComStation, right? It's like a successor of OS 2. For me, it's like a historical moment. It was like the first time I'm trying OS 2, so I just want to share my inspiration with you guys. And even by using it, I was actually really, really interested how it all worked, how the UI is more advanced, how it's more stable. I mean, it's really cool. Just a bit of history. IBM and Microsoft both worked together on OS 2. It was like a collaborative effort, but seems like something went wrong along the lines, and like around 1990 when Windows 3.0 was released, something went wrong there. Both were like not satisfied with how things are going, and Microsoft Windows 3.0 was a great success at that time, so people chosen Windows more than OS 2, right? So Microsoft decided like, hey, we're gonna just grab this bunch of this kernel code base and just use it on Windows later on. But of course Microsoft rewrote a bunch of modules and it's completely different operating system now. OS 2 and Windows, they both had some shared libraries, shared codes, shared stuff, and many applications were written that way that like they are able to be executed on both OS 2 and Windows. And in fact there's like Windows 3 point something version included on OS 2 itself, and you can execute Windows 3 point something applications easily. Like basically all 16-bit Windows applications are executed in OS 2 without any problems, like very, very simple to use. And also DOS application, they provide very good compatibility with DOS applications as well. So I mean, even for that reason using OS 2 is great. Probably like for old games it's like it's a really good decision to like try OS 2 instead of let's say DOSBox. At least something to consider. The main problem why OS 2 was not that popular is because, well, because of the marketing, and also because most of the drivers were available for Windows, and it was really hard to get drivers for OS 2. Like IBM decided like, we provide drivers only for our hardware, we're not that open. And as you can see, it was actually very, very bad decision at because if they decided to be open to everybody, if they decided like to provide the stuff, if they were more open, probably they got more attention and more people will switch to OS 2 rather than Windows. But history is history, right? So, well, OS 2 is basically not used anymore, only like enthusiasts are using it, right? So mostly Windows, and for this reason, yeah, it's sad because it was more advanced compared to Windows. There are many technologies more advanced. So let's actually try how OS 2 works, because like talk is cheap, right? I can talk a lot of stuff like OS 2 is great and advanced and all stuff, but without actually examples of how it works, well, you probably won't not gonna believe me, right? So for this reason, so let's go ahead and try that. Alright, so it's my good old Lenovo T61 and we're gonna boot eComStation demo CD right there. Alright, so this is like a typical start menu. And as you can see, it actually loads diskettes into the memory. So it's like, this is how it works. It actually loads those there. This floppy restriction is just crazy. I don't know. Alright, I heard some beeps. Probably it means something, but I don't know what it means. Processors initialized 1. Alright, it loads some additional drivers. Setting up the desktop. Yeah, it's nice. Guys, I actually initially wanted to show you the virtual machine with OS 2 installed and all that. But then I decided, like, why not just try the demo CD? Because, I mean, showing the virtual machine, it's not actually like being true to my audience, right? I mean, what is virtual machine? Everybody can just like use virtual machine, but like running on actual hardware, I mean, this is like much more interesting. And in the next episodes, I'm probably gonna install it on actual hardware and try it, because I don't know, I don't like virtual machine. Virtual machines are like the last resort. Like if nothing really works, then I try virtual machine, but otherwise it's much more interesting to try an actual bare metal. Alright, so it's all loaded and the first thing that we see is this help page, which basically like shows you what you can do with the OS and how you can manage, how you can customize it and all that. And it's really interesting, I guess, to read, but of course you're not gonna read. The first thing that I was confused is like those buttons is like, is it like gonna minimize? No, it's gonna close. And what about this one? Is it gonna, well, no, it's not gonna. So this is minimize, I guess. This is maximize. I mean, I was confused. This is close, yeah, like according to the icon. But I actually changed the theme to OS 2 Warp, this theme was actually even more confusing. So I was like, oh my gosh, so confusing. A very interesting thing that after we open the local system, there's a command prompts folder. And when we open it, in this version, there's only like command prompt window, command prompt full screen. So in the demo CD, they have removed the Win 3.1 and DOS command prompts. Like obviously they didn't want it to have it shipped by default, I guess, but on the virtual machine I have all those. So on the virtual machine, as you can see, I have command prompts. When you open the local system in the command prompts, it shows much more options here. And for example, it has Windows 16 session full screen, Windows 16 session window, and the same goes for the DOS session, which is really cool. And for example, I can open it like this. And here it is, the full-fledged version of Windows 3.something running here. For me, it's really exciting. And if you go and press run and type winver, it's gonna show you the version of Windows. It's basically like the whole version of Windows 3.1 shipped here. It's like really nice. File manager is shipped here by default. We're gonna minimize it, and here it is. So the program manager, it's running here with Windows, and you can open any applications. For example, the Star Office I have here, and it's also running right from there. It works just fine, so you can have two applications running side by side with two very different environments, which is, I mean, this is really nice, I think. Control panel, you probably got even confused, like which OS are you running right here, but as you can see, it has this yellow stuff around, so you know this, okay, this is the Windows, and this is the OS 2, well, I mean, eComStation. So yeah, guys, this is like how it works in real time, and I seriously considering, instead of using my DOS box, using this one, which is like really cool for running Windows applications. And here, like, it's really, really strange to see that in an operating system that is quite that long. I mean, we have virtual desktops right here, which is like really cool. And then you can go to properties and then you can customize, like, for example, like one. I mean, I never use virtual desktops. I'm probably just gonna disable it. But here, what we have? We have games. They have ported some games there. It's actually a completely different set of stuff than comparing to actual installation. Like those games are not shipped in actual installation. They're like other games. Just a typical fun back in those days. Yeah, it was really funny to play such kind of games. But here it's interesting. There is like in Windows I have like programs and all that, but here we have desktop, and then you open here, it's like, okay, we have also programs here, but it's just confusing. Like this menu looks so small compared to Windows, very, very different. For example, what's interesting there? It's interesting thing here is the Firefox. eComStation compared to actual OS 2 has the Firefox ported over. There are actually ways to install quite modern version of Firefox, and I've been trying to do it on a virtual machine and it didn't work. So yeah, I was not able to install the latest version of Firefox on my virtual machine, but here, which one is like 10.0.12? Yeah, I mean, it's quite old. Let's go somewhere, for example, YouTube. Yeah, YouTube doesn't like this browser, it looks too old. Then the connection doesn't work, there are some problems. So browsing web is not really a thing here. Like you can probably browse some very, very basic websites, but I mean, this old version of Firefox doesn't really work with modern websites. I've been trying to install some latest version of Firefox, but I don't know, it doesn't work when you launch it. It just shows this, which means it's not really running. But I actually like the way how to create shortcuts. So when you right click on some application, and then you drag, you just notice how it looks like Firefox that executable. And when you press it, yeah, it just says cannot start because there's something is wrong, it doesn't work. A component DLL is missing, but I actually plugged all the DLLs right here, so it actually should work. I don't know, guys, why it didn't work. There are some applications shipped which is called Q Metro. I guess it's like a subway map or something. Oh yeah, what it allowed most cities? No. And you can actually navigate the city this way. Utilities, what do we have here? We have the typical text editor that you find on any operating system. Yeah, typical text editor. Calculator. Yeah, actually looks quite nice. Toolbar. There is an application called Toolbar. And it's actually interesting. Oh yeah, it can show you the window list and it can show you the information. And yeah, quite nice. This looks much more complex compared to, like, let's say Windows, like 98 or something. It's much more stuff available here. And for example, the templates, like what is the templates? And here you can create program, and then you can create this, like, select a folder as a target for this operation. It looks like much more advanced kind of system comparing to Windows 98. It's more like Windows NT or something, even probably more advanced. So on a right click, there is actually a bunch of actions available here. Some options are quite strange, like for example, open parent. Oh yeah, it opens the parent. No, it's actually quite nice. Sort, okay, there's sorting capabilities. Sort and arrange. Okay, so this is like additional options available here. View, tree view details. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. This is really interesting, guys. You can have like tree view, like a and then for example, here's the system setup, and there you have system settings. System settings is interesting. In case if it's Windows, there's also additional options for Windows 16 customization for Windows application, all that. But what's interesting here, for example, this one, Registry Editor. I never thought that registry is available on operating systems other than Windows, but as you can see, it's available on IS2. To be honest, I don't even like know how it works here. Maybe it's for some compatibility with Windows. Maybe I don't know what is the real reason for using this. But this registry seems to have much less stuff here. For example, like much less trees. And then appearance. Of course, you can change your appearance. For example, the e-styler preferences. Yeah, you can change some stuff here, like enable title bar enhancement, apply. Okay, well, this looks much more like Windows now. And there are some additional customization available, changing the complete color scheme here, like very interesting actually. Of course, you can change the screen resolution here, and here like the tabs. Correct me if I'm wrong, but the tabs are not that used back in the 90s. This concept of tabs were like more introduced more recently, but this is quite interesting actually, so I like it. And this feels like more actually like usage of the tabs, and then you can press here, like there are like multiple pages, you can switch between those pages, so they're like much more advanced kind of UI compared to Windows. It's actually a shame that this OS is not that popular as it could be. Also take a look at the quick launch, right? We call it quick launch in Windows, but this is looks very, very interesting here. It's a command prompt. You can launch a bunch of different command prompts from here. Then you can open applications, some system applications from here. Then you can access directly the drives from there. And then it's probably showing the CPU usage and all the graphs. And then when you open the local system, and when you open drives, take a look how cool is that. When you open any drive, let's say drive D, Yeah, we have this kind of tree structure here, which is kind of nice. My gosh, I mean, I'm always confused by those button location. Like, this one is like, feels like maximize according to icon, but then now it just like, ah. Yeah, so this is like OS 2 is the folder where OS 2 system is located. System that, user that. By the way, take a look at how interesting to turn off the computer. You press shut down. It has those options, shutdown only, standard reboot, and also has an option to empty trash can, which was like really cool option actually. I mean, let's say standard reboot, for example, and then press OK. Then it shows the progress right here of shutting down the applications, and then boom, that's it.